أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد النبي العاشر الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Like every Thursday, we talk about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his biography, his lifetime, as an attempt to extract some lessons from his life and to put it into action. So the point when we talk about the biography of the Prophet Muhammad is not just telling his stories, rather it's a way of life. Because as we all agree upon that our uswa, our role model, is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then we should know more about his lifetime so we'll be able to practice. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنٌ. And we've been commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to obey the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to follow his sunnah. وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ. Obey Allah and obey the Messenger. And also, our obedience and our following to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is considered as if we follow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah's way. Because they are both the same. Everything that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought to us is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ يُطِعَ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهُ. Whoever obeys the Messenger, he's obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one more thing, we all believe that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the seal and the last of the Prophets. And we do love him. And if you ask each and every one individually, do you love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Who would definitely say yes. But we need to prove this love by following his way. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ. We love Allah. Why? Because of everything. Because he granted us this life, the gift of life. He granted us the health, the wealth, the children. He granted us everything, the mind to function, the heart to feel. He granted us everything. That's why we love him subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah the Almighty. So if we love him, then we should follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why we gather each and every Thursday for a few minutes. We are trying our best not to make it long, but just to get the lessons and to get the benefit from this gathering. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to make the most of our gathering every night and every morning. Allahumma ameen. So last time we were talking about that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after he has endured a lot of pain and a lot of attack and a lot of harm from the disbelievers, he decided to go to a Taif, this place after his wife, Sayyidah Khadija, may Allah be pleased with her, and his uncle, Abu Talib. The two persons that were supporting him all the time, they passed away in the same year. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went out trying to find some support in terms of following him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He started to call to the way of Allah and letting people know about this great message. But people at that time did not believe in him. And they did not leave him alone. They started to chase him everywhere he goes. And everyone who follows his risala and his message and his way, the disbelievers started to harm and attack them everywhere. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam raised his hand to Allah as he authorized this very soft and very heartfelt dua when he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allahumma ilayka ashku dha'fa quwwati wa qillata hilati wa hawani 'ala an-nas, till the end of this dua. Oh Allah, I just complain to you my weakness amongst people, my not being able to confront these waves of, you know, attacking and chasing from the disbelievers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him in a journey, which is a miracle. and will be a miracle to the Day of Judgment. And you know that every prophet that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had sent was supported with some of the miracles, some signs, each and every prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to take his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the night journey. We call it al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. Subhanallazi asra. Can I just say it starts subhanallazi asra bi'abdihi? Or should I say bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim? Who knows?
Bismillah.
Why? Great. MashaAllah. Now we try to connect things together. Because when we talk about tajweed, on Sundays we say that when you start at the beginning of surah, you should say bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Great. Alhamdulillah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Subhanallazi asra bi'abdihi layl. Min al-masjid al-haram. Ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is praising himself, glorifying himself, and then he said, Abidihi, his servant, his slave. And this is the highest level. So long as we are servants of Allah, we are elevated in this life, and our status is high. The more we humble ourselves to Allah, the more our status will be high in this life and in the hereafter. And then Quran tells us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in al-Masjid al-Haram. Where is al-Masjid al-Haram? In Mecca. In al-Masjid al-Aqsa. Where is al-Masjid al-Aqsa? Palestine, Jerusalem. Just imagine that this area and this distance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his Prophet through the night to this place. And on top of that, he took him in a journey to the seven heavens, and a lot of incidents happened during this incident and during this journey. Inshallah, we'll talk about it in detail in this anniversary. It shall be inshallah very soon. And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam achieved the point, he got back after everything done. He started to tell people that I was at al-Masjid al-Aqsa. And Allah took me in this journey, and I went to the seven heavens, and I met the Prophet Ibrahim, and I met this, and I met that. Allah prescribed prayer, as we will come to cover, inshallah, very soon. All of these things, of course, the disbelievers, again, did not believe in this. And one of the things why Abu Bakr as-Siddiq is called as-Siddiq, the truthful man, the most truthful man, because he always supports the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he always believed in him. The people went to Abu Bakr wa qalu inna sahibaka yaqul innahu usriya bihi min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa wa uruja bihi ila al-samawati al-ulya kullu hadha athna'i ilayhi faqad in kana qalaha faqad sadaq. If he really said that he was in this journey from al-masjid al-haram to al-masjid al-aqsa, and he has been taken to the seven heavens and saw all of these signs and miracles, if he really said that, then he is truthful. I believe in him. That's why we always say Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after this journey, still the disbelievers chasing him. Why? Just ask yourself, even in our day-to-day life, we see that a lot of people might claim things, might publish or post things on the social media. Some people might say, I'm a new prophet. But you will find that nobody cares about this man, because he's nothing. And some people might claim even that they are a God that controls everything. But people do not care about them. Why did the disbelievers were all the time chasing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and trying to block his message from reaching to the people and trying to separate people from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Because they know, and they themselves were calling him as-Sadiq al-Amin, the most truthful, the most honest person. And they know that if he talks to people, people will believe him, because he never tells lies, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they know that. That's why they tried everything possible to block his message from reaching to people. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised, وَجَعَلَ كَلِمَةَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا السُّفْلَى وَكَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا. The word of Allah is supreme, is the highest. It's ups and downs. This is how the life is. Even inside our own selves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَفِي أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Even our status of iman goes up and down. Our faith increases and decreases, depending on our practicing of the deen. Sometimes we are in a great status of connecting with God, with Allah. And sometimes we are just indulging into the material life and just forgetting about even remembering Allah. This is how the life is, you know. It's like we're trying to make a balance. That's why we always ask Allah to give us the assistance. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, later on the, especially on the 11th year of his death, you know, they started to count from the time when the revelation came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam before Hijrah. Now we're not even getting to the Hijrah. This in the 11th year of this death, of this message, when he got the first revelation from the angel Jibreel alayhi salam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam met some people. They said there were 7 people. And he offered Islam to them. And he talked to them about the, you know, importance of this Islam and the greatness of this Islam and how it is important to join Islam, because he said sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he is the last messenger and he is promising people of paradise, of Jannah, if they follow his way and this bringing peace. And he started to call them to Islam and they believed in him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Those people went back to Al-Madinah and they started also to call people to Islam. Focus with this. They started to call people to Islam. And again, the people of Mecca were very busy about this point. They don't like, again, once again, they don't like the mission and the risala and the message of the Prophet Muhammad to be spread and to be dominant. They're chasing anyone just thinking about following the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because they know that he was true and his message is real sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the next year, another group of people came to Mecca. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, also those people were from 2 tribes called Al-Aws and Al-Khazraj. Those 2 tribes, قبيلتان في المدينة كانت تسمى قديما يثرب. فأتوا إلى مكة وقابلهم النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وبايعوا. سميت هذه البيعة العقبة الأولى. العقبة هو مكان قرب منى. عادة البيعة أو الوعد covenant promise that they take and they have some conditions in it. They refer to this promise or to this covenant with the place where it held or even a place near to this place, just to be, you know, famous for, you know, this bay'ah or this covenant. والآية التي وضحت ذلك أتت في أواخر سورة الممتحنة. بايعهم على ماذا؟ ألا يشرك بالله شيئا ولا يسرق ولا يزني ولا يقتل أولادهن ولا يأتين بالبهتان يفترينه بين أيديهن وأرجلهن ولا بعد ذلك ولا تين بهتانا فرما بين أيديهن وأرجلهن ولا نعم للأكثر ولا يسرقن ولا يزنين ولا يأتين ببهتان يفترينه بين أيديهن وأرجلهن ولا يعصينك في معروف ولا يعصينك في معروف بارك الله فيك. So you feel that all of these conditions are basics, because at that time Islam and Muslims were not, you know, a considerable power. They still at the beginning. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam trying to, you know, to take care of the basics. Never steal, never commit adultery, fornication, never, you know, disobey the Prophet. Just like basics, the things that fix the heart, And the next year, those people, you know, got back to Medina again, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent with them one of the companions. His name is Mus'ab ibn Umayr. Why? To teach people the deen of Allah, to teach people the religion. And at that time, the people of Medina started to join Islam and to convert, because they found the truth. They found that that thing actually touched the heart. And this bay'ah, the second one, also called bay'ah al-Aqaba al-Thaniya, the second bay'ah, also at the same place, which is al-Aqaba, which is very close to Mina. What we want to say is, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whenever he got a chance to call people, to gather them, to talk to them about religion, and to send one of the companions to this tribe, to this city, to this place, to teach people. Because he wants his message to spread and to be dominant. Because he knows that his message is the reality that the people actually need. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, since he got the first revelation, since then, all humanity are in need to the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And people still discover and find out a lot of things that the Prophet and the Quran actually talked about like 14 centuries ago. And the science still discovering a lot of things that is so related and even is discussed in details in Quran. Like the stages of the fetus into the womb of the pregnant woman. If you get back to Surah Al-Mu'minun, you would find how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the stages of, from the very beginning, the stages of this fetus into the womb of a pregnant woman, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him عَلَقًا تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ مُضْغَةٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ عَلَقَةٍ ثُمَّ مِنْ مُضْغَةٍ مُخَلَّقَةٍ وَغَيْرُ مُخَلَّقَةٍ وَالْعِظَامُ. You would find that every stage is discussed in this surah. That's why you find a lot of, you know, scholars who are interested in this branch of knowledge. Some of them just converted to Islam because of this one single verse in Surah Al-Mu'minun. And a lot of things like وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ, the sapphire is under the water. We say that the water, just if you pour a water on top of fire, it will be vanished, it will be, you know, gone. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated that وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ, that there is a fire under the water. And recently we found out that there is a fire under the water. A lot of things, you know, this is just one or two examples. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions, they all sacrificed, and they did the utmost sacrifice in the history of humanity, so we could enjoy our religion now. Everything is accessible. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facilitated the way for us to gather and to pray in this comfortable carpet, in this place, in the masjid, when we could turn on the heat, and sometimes we turn on the cold air. Alhamdulillah, Allah gives us everything. The people at, you know, at the past, at the time of the Prophet, they were praying on the dust, on the dirt, on the things that you can't even walk on top of it. They endured too much. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised one more time, وَكَلِمَةُ اللَّهِ هِيَ الْعُلْيَا. The word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is supreme and will be supreme, inshaAllah, till the day of judgment. نسأل الله أن يعلمنا وإياكم ما ينفعنا وأن ينفعنا بما يعلمنا وأن يزيدنا علما وربنا على خير. نبتدئ إن شاء الله. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.